This is the roll call room that I was telling you about where we start our morning off with the officers. Sergeant will stand up here in the front of the room. In training, we have the ability to have the board set up here so we can do training, classroom training. And we have the TV up here so we're able to do any kind of videos. There's bulletins in the back that the officers can keep up to date with. And any of the forms that they would need to perform their duties are in the back of this room. So when they come in, this is where they get all the forms that they need. This is a very popular form right here for the traffic crashes. So this is a basic form of what an officer would have to fill out if they were to do a traffic crash. That's only page one. So there's many other pages to it on. There's the other pages, front and back. You have the other page here. You have to draw a diagram on the back. So there's a lot of paperwork that comes with this job.
Get yourself some cover. Show me your hands.
5465 valid 03 Mercury Grand.
Put your hands to your side.
Put your hands down.
Hands to your side.
Fuck you. I'm one of you. I'm one of you.
Get on the ground, sir. Hands up. Sir, drop the gun. We don't want to kill you. We will.
He still has the gun, he still has the gun. Hell, he's on the other side of the
track. Put it down!
We need assistance at 4900 Hoover. We got 415 there with a gun.
When an officer calls for assistance, that means that pretty much all of us go. Because on a call that requires two officers, we always send the two officers. If a person has to wait for their backup, they will. All of our officers are very well trained, so they make sure that they're safe. But sometimes things go a little bit of a different route. If an officer loses their life in the line of duty, many officers will wear what's called a mourning badge, and that goes over their badge. It's a badge cover, and you can either wear just a black badge cover or you can wear the thin blue line cover, which basically you're paying your respects and you're honoring those that lost their lives in the line of duty. So I wear this as an everyday reminder to pay tribute to those people that have lost their lives and given the ultimate sacrifice, but I also wear it to remind myself to stay safe and always go home to my family at night. Sometimes people file complaints and they say that an officer did something. Well, if we look at the video and we look at the audio, it can show that the officer didn't do anything, and perhaps, you know, people try to say things that didn't actually happen to get themselves out of a ticket. More call volume for us, but you still run into various kinds of people, which is good, because like I said earlier, you learn different things and meet new people, and that's what this job is about.
Well, I saw a four, I thought.
sits and does their work. And usually the prisoner will sit right here and we handcuff them either to the bench, most likely. And they sit here and the officer is able to ask them questions. We have the bathrooms, we have fingerprinting area. It's a holding facility, so after they can sit in here while we're doing their paperwork, but then we end up taking them down to Fort Lauderdale, and Fort Lauderdale ends up processing them.
My mom was a nurse, so I thought I wanted to do the medical side. I became a paramedic and firefighter. When we started being a paramedic, I was out of this station as a paramedic, and I got to know the police officers, saw what they did, and when I got my chance to become hired here, I figured I'd take it and try it out, and I loved it.
There are people out there that recognize the hazards that we have to go through on a daily basis just to maintain their safety. There are people that are not so happy to see the police because we are the ones that respond to calls when people need assistance with something. And sometimes the assistance may require us to arrest a spouse or arrest a child or arrest somebody that's a family member, and they may not be too happy about that. So their experience with the police may be that it was an encounter that somebody in their family got arrested. So those people may not necessarily respect the police.
Shots fired.
Hands up! Hands up! 32. Keep your hands where I can see them. I will kill you. I don't want to.